After watching this edit, you will know exactly all the steps that are taken into building your snowboard so that next time you ride, you're gonna know exactly what's under your feet. To help me in this hard process, I've got here Selim and Thibaut, who've been designing and running basically this first track lab. So they're gonna be my masters today. So we've been working on this evolution of the 161 of the XV, which is my pro model from Rossignol. And we're trying to basically widen it, like make it a bit more playful. And yeah, we're gonna be testing different technologies and different materials that are more sustainable. So here is what we came up with. Slightly wider board so that you can ride shorter and more playful. The pintail here is a bit of an element. I've been adding a bit of width here, changing the shape of the tail. Having a fatter nose as well. So we kept the normal camber under the feet. And there used to be a rocker and a taper going from the tail. And with this model, we're trying to have a more traditional tail. I think that's the big difference. So that's the difference. Whereas before, it used to be more like up, so it was harder kind of to stomp jumps and things. So first step is to cut the wood core. So we've entered all the parameters in the machine and it does the job automatically. Clean all the edges so that you have a clean piece of wood to work with. So here we've got bamboo and polonia. So the goal of having the two wood cores is to bring a bit more pop and a bit more reactivity. The bamboo has got a great flex, great durability, and the polonia is really light and it doesn't suck too much resin. So we're basically giving the right thickness we want exactly where we want it. So you will understand the thinner it is, the more flex it has, and the thicker it is, the harder it is. So depending on what you want, how you want to ride, you're gonna shape your wood core differently. Like Lego. So this is what's gonna hold the bindings, the inserts. There are different based options, and here we use polyethylene. This is high density, so it can get rocks. It holds the wax better, and it rides like a rocket. Woo! It is still, unfortunately, a plastic, but any offcuts can be recycled straight away so that there's no waste. So it's time for the edges now. Woohoo! Getting real. We're gonna pincer it so that it stays together, and we're gonna bend the ends so that it fits really well to the base.
Whoa!
Then it's time to glue the edge. It's important to be really precise there so that you're not gonna get any gap between the base and the edge. Let's open it. There's gonna be four layers of fiberglass, so it's important to choose which type you want, depending how the fibers are woven and the directions of it. So that's what's gonna define the rigidity, the torsion, and all the specs of the board, along with the wood core. Now let's get serious. Making a snowboard is basically like making a sandwich. You've got all these layers that you need to get together, and you need to put a bit of mayonnaise in the middle so that it can stick together. So here the mayonnaise is resin. So this resin is made from waste from the industry. So we keep away waste that should have gone into the landfill and still use it to ride on it. How beautiful. And by the way, thanks to Burger King for making this possible. First, we're gonna be spreading out all the resin, and then we're gonna put this rubber on the edge so that it kind of bonds better. So it needs to go beyond the edge. So we're gonna have four layers of fiber to lay down. So that's the base, we've got the resin, and that's gonna be a fiber that's unidirectional, which is one direction, and then we're gonna play with other directions to work on the flex the way we want. Next coat of resin. Game on. It's getting real now. So now the next layer. So it's going to be a three-directional fiber. Love this feeling. Okay. Alignment is key at this stage because you want to be exactly above the edges. Next layer of fiber, so that's a mono-directional one again. So with 45 degrees angle fibers. And now bamboo top sheet. It's a really thin slice of bamboo, which we're gonna draw on later. So now we have to be careful not to stain it. Now we close the lid. So we've been shaping with a CNC machine these pre-shapes so that we're gonna have exactly the shape we want for the nose and tail.
That's our tail.
So now we're gonna put the sandwich into the panini machine. Panini time. Up. All right, sandwich time. So the machine does not only press the board, but it also heats it to 85 degrees so that the glue is gonna bond. So it's gonna be a strong board. Getting the baby out of the oven. It's like Christmas. You see it, but you don't know what's inside. Yoo-hoo! All right. But, oh, it's square. Nice. Nice. Trop bien. It's not Ali G, it's me if you haven't recognized. Now we're gonna give a bit of an angle to the sidewalls. Now we're gonna clean it a little bit before we do the graphics, the finish coats, and then it's good to go. Woohoo! Graphic time. So now we've got the bare board and we're gonna try to screen print a photo of the landscape that we see here in Verbier with all the runs that I've done over the years and the runs that I loved.
Okay.
So that's in
the line. Oh, putain. Shit.
You guys good?
Yeah.
All right, yeah, 3, 2, 1. So you do beneath side first. Wow. That looks good.
Quick sanding to soften it up a tiny bit.
Throughout the years, I've ridden a lot of those peaks and a lot of the peaks even I haven't ridden, but I find them really aesthetic for either for climbing or for riding. And yeah, I don't know. This is kind of putting a little note on all the little things that have meant a lot to me, or that still mean a lot, or that will mean a lot.
We'll be right back. Now let's drill the inserts. It's the moment to not fuck it up.
So now the finishing touch, the varnish, so that all the graphic doesn't move in time and on snow. Guess we can't go back now. There she is. I think I'll sleep with her tonight. Don't mind, darling? No.